Welcome back to Spell Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about joint variation. And a joint variation is seen by the equation y equals kxz, where again k is the constant of variation. And a note that I want to make here is that a joint variation is very similar to a direct variation, which is just y equals kx. All we've done is introduced a new factor z, so basically done in the same manner. And also we know that if it's a joint or direct variation, we're going to always go through the origin here at 0, 0 if we're asked to depict that from a graph. So let's begin by reading the question. The volume of a cone V varies jointly as its height h and the square of its radius r. So here we see the varies jointly. And the volume V is going to correspond to the y. So, as a matter of fact, I'll put that down here. So V is equal to the constant of variation k. The x is going to be the height. So I'm just going to put h here. So that's in place of the x variable. And the square of the radius. And r squared is going to be in the position that the z is holding. Again, to solve these problems, we have to do two equations, basically the same equation with different missing pieces, so that we can find out what they're asking for. So in this particular example, let's rewrite the equation up here. V equals KHR squared. All right, they've told us that a cone has the radius measuring 6 feet, so I'm going to put the 6 in place of the r, and this also needs to be squared. And it has a height of 10, so 10 goes in place of the h. Again, I'm using parentheses here. We don't know the constant of variation, but we do know that the volume is 120 pi. So we begin to solve this again by using the order of operations. We have to do exponents first. 6 squared is 36. And then, of course, we continue to rewrite to bring down each part of the equation. 10 times 36 is 360. To isolate k, I divide both sides by 360. Those cancel, leaving me with the value of k at 120 pi divided by 360. Here I see that I can first divide by 10 to get rid of those zeros, and then I see I can divide by 12. 12 divided by 12 leaves me with 1, so I can just leave the pi at the top, and then 36 divided by 12 gives me 3. So I found my constant of variation to be pi thirds. Now I go to the question, or to find what they're asking. They want to find the volume of a cone having a radius of 12 feet and a height of 2 feet. So, don't know the volume. Here we do know the constant of variation, which is pi over 3, or 1/3 pi. The height, we see the height is 2, and we see that the radius here is 12, but we need to square it because of what it says here and the square of its radius. So let's go ahead, order of operations first, which means we have to do the 12 squared, which is 144. Then we multiply 2 times 144 to give me 288 pi. All that's going to be divided by 3. And let's see, 3 goes into 288. 3 times, 9 to give me 27 with 1 left over. 3 goes into 18, 6 times. So I see here that I'm left with 96 pi, which would be the volume of the cone that they're speaking of in this problem. All right, that sums it up for this video by Spell Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to that YouTube channel to see more of our videos. And as always, thank you again for watching.